I'm a super senior geology major at Middlebury, also a Spanish minor. So I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. I had never even heard of Middlebury. I had barely even thought twice about the state of Vermont. All I knew was that Cabot was there, and I love Cabot cheddar cheese. That's about it. But discovered Middlebury, came and visited, found that the physical environment was exactly what I wanted, and I remember I actually had this dream of me biking around the Champlain Valley, and that was when I was a senior in high school, right in the fall, almost exactly 5 years ago. And here we are now, which is pretty funny. A lot of time has passed, and it's nice to look back on it in a very favorable light. So I got into bike riding also when I was a senior in high school. It wasn't anything crazy. It was just going on my like kind of flat barred hybrid bike around town, feeling like I was really cool. I wasn't really cool. But stayed interested in it. I never quite did it super competitively or went for speed or anything else like that. It was purely to explore the city around me, again, Nashville, Tennessee. But it wasn't until I got to Middlebury that I realized I wanted to go out and explore Vermont a little bit more. And I met one of my friends, Cole, and he's now a very good friend of mine. And he took me out for this 20-mile bike ride, and I absolutely fell in love with it. And I wanted to keep doing it. Very quickly, I got into the Middlebury Cycling Club, and I did my first bike race with them. That also was met with a lot of enthusiasm, and I thought it was a great experience. And I wasn't positive I wanted to keep on racing, but I knew I wanted to keep riding bikes, and I knew I wanted to do it both in an exploratory way, but also in a semi-competitive fashion as well. That winter, I came in February, and when that spring came and passed, I begged my parents for a new bike. They were happy enough to oblige, took a little bit of convincing. Rode all summer, came back in the fall, and was ready to go. I rode almost, I think, 2,500 miles that fall. Spent over 30 hours on my bike just in those 3.5 months. From there, I mean, I would like to say it's the same old, but every ride, even if it's the same ride, still is different in some way. And it keeps things fresh, so I can say even after almost 4 years, it still feels like a new experience almost every single time. So I think the beautiful thing about riding my bike is that it's very simple. Obviously the componentry can get a little complicated and it's really easy to get caught up in things, but the act of hopping on your bike, turning the pedals and going somewhere is, to me, about as simple as it gets. I'm really grateful for that, especially because at Middlebury I have this really great habit of trying to make everything that I touch really complicated. I'm not really proud to say that. So it's really nice when, at the end of the day, when I'm really having a hard time, I can hop on my bike and feel like I'm just doing something it's about as simple as it gets. It feels a little raw. At times it feels a little animalistic, just chasing after something that's really not there. It really manifested especially in my ride today because I just finished up chemistry lab. this is one of my last classes I have to take at Middlebury. It's what will help me get into grad school, and it's also something that I don't want to do at all. And it's a frustrating process, and it's one that I don't always understand. So coming off of that today and feeling really frustrated, I'm really not exaggerating when I say there's nothing more liberating than just hopping on my bike and doing something that feels intuitive, it feels simple, and it feels like something that I don't even have to think about anymore. Oftentimes, I end up riding alone, and I think that it's a very vulnerable process. It's one where you're out there on the road, the cars are around you, and it's just kind of you and them. And at times it's vulnerable, but like I said, it's quite liberating. With that being said, I've also been very lucky to have gotten in contact with other cyclists, three of whom are some of my closest friends today. And I think in a lot of ways that changed both who I spent my time with at Middlebury, but also the connections I was able to make with them. Certainly one of my friends and I, we rode up Lincoln Gap together, and we felt awful almost the entire time. But the act of being able to do that together, of being in such a bad place, but such a good place, it really brought me, I feel like I became so much closer to him in that moment, and it's a moment that's really resonated with me ever since. And it's really played into a lot of my friendships as well. I think some of my best moments with my friends have been on bikes. I think there's a lot to be said for that, and many other moments that I hope to come. Thank you.